Aerial photos show that SpaceX has rapidly begun building the first of two planned skyscraper-sized Starship launch towers in South Texas, towers that could one day catch the Super Heavy boosters out of the air with huge arms. CEO Elon Musk first revealed that outlandish Starship booster recovery plan around the turn of the year, followed 3 months later by an even wilder claim that the same booster-catching tower could also catch Starships. Around the time the idea was first floated, SpaceX was beginning to build one of two planned towers that might be outfitted with arms in the future. Progress was mostly invisible at first, hinted at only by the presence of a self-propelled drill in a few muddy holes in the right spot. By mid-March, SpaceX had begun clearing away some of the dirt on top, revealing a beefy foundation with 25 2-foot-thick, approximately 1-meter piles, buried at least 100 feet 30 meters deep in the sandy wetlands. 2 weeks later, the foundation has been encased in concrete and the framework for massive base is nearly ready for its first concrete pour. In other words, SpaceX's first South Texas launch tower has just begun to take shape and grow vertically. First and foremost, its purpose is to provide an extremely sturdy base, with which SpaceX can install Super Heavy boosters on the launch mount, and then install Starships on top of those boosters. Standing at least 122 meters, approximately 395 feet tall from tip to tail, without even accounting for the launch mount stand Starship will attach to, that seemingly simple task ends up being not so simple at all. Situated less than a mile from the Gulf of Mexico, Boca Chica is typically an extremely windy environment at sea level, let alone hundreds of feet above ground, and the South Texas coast is almost constantly at risk of torrential rain, thunderstorms, hurricanes, and flooding. As far as building giant, sturdy towers and performing work as sensitive and precise as vertically mating rocket stages, it's hard to imagine a viable launch site with less favorable conditions short of Siberia or the Russian steppe. According to Musk, SpaceX's Boca Chica launch tower will have a hook height, the distance from the crane hook to the ground, of at least 140 meters, approximately 460 feet. Meaning that the top of the tower's crane will likely be 150 to 160 meters, 490 to 520 feet tall. When configured to mate Starship to Super Heavy. Beyond those general details and the occasional official SpaceX render of possible launch facilities, not much else is known about how Boca Chica's launch tower will look and function, particularly with respect to vague plans to catch Super Heavy boosters. However, SpaceX appears to have aggressively turned its attention to building out Boca Chica's first orbital launch facilities, and the progress made in the last 2 months suggests that it won't be long before. What was recently a dirt apron will be ready to support Starship and Super Heavy testing. According to Musk, SpaceX's internal goal is to attempt Starship and Super Heavy's first orbital launch as early as July 2021. If the company continues to work around the clock on rocket's orbital launch site as it has for the last 2 months, it's far from inconceivable that the pad will be ready for that orbital launch debut even if Starship is not. Stay tuned for more updates as the pad and launch tower continue to take shape. The next Starship prototype to launch will be the SN15. There was to be a relative pause in Starship test flights after SN11, with SN15 sporting new upgrades that will push the vehicle to new heights ahead of the orbital flight later this year. Test objectives for SN15 are unknown at this time, with options including a repeat of the SN8-11 test objectives, utilizing the known flight parameters while shaking out the improvements to the vehicle, through to pushing to a much higher target altitude. SpaceX had built the SN12, but parts of it have been scrapped. The SN13 and SN14 had parts made for it, but SpaceX decided to not complete the rockets. Instead, it will jump straight to the SN15, which SpaceX chief Elon Musk says has improved capabilities and will be the company's best chance at landing. As is custom with SpaceX, it has not provided an exact launch date, with fans likely to experience a weeks-long wait. Mr. Musk said on Twitter, SN15 rolls to launch pad in a few days. It has hundreds of design improvements across structures, avionics, software and engine. Hopefully, one of those improvements covers this problem. If not, then retrofit will add a few more days. While the SN15 will be fitted with small changes, eccentric billionaire Mr. Musk said the next major review will come when the SN20 launches. However, even he is not confident the SN20 will be a complete success, stating the later batch of Starships will take a more challenging flight. Mr. Musk added, next major technology rev is at SN20. Those ships will be orbit capable with heat shield and stage separation system. Ascent success probability is high. However, SN20+ vehicles will probably need many flight attempts to survive Mach 25 entry heating and land intact. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe, because we make all sorts of content, some like this, and some not like this. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover next, whether it's Starship or not, please comment it below.